Welcome. This is the Thrift Store Rundown, where we bring Hollywood home on a budget. In this context, any time is the right time to be in Jeopardy. Yet the timing for this video cannot be more right. And that all comes down to three simple words. Pretty Little Liars. What? Well, one of my all-time favorite shows, PLL, was a Jeopardy category, not once, but twice. However, this coming Sunday, on the new Celebrity Jeopardy, which isn't anything new to us, they've done this before back in the 90s. But anyway, this Sunday night on ABC, the prettiest little liar of them all, and definitely the most sharpest and smartest and wittiest, to huggy on and on and on, will officially compete and raise money for the War Child Foundation. I bet you know who that is.
Just assume it's Spencer, you know, slutting it up.
Oh yes, that's my baby Spencer. Even though my love for Troian Bellisario has pretty much died down over the course of a year or so, but never fully gone away. Longtime viewers of this channel, especially fellow PLL fans, will know that for many years I was devastatingly in love with Troian Bellisario. Never mind madly in love, I had photos of this woman hanging on my wall, which I call my wall of endgame, or my PLL paraphernalia, near my workstation. Those photos have since been taken down, save for one photo of Troian that I still have on the side wall, which ain't coming down, period, until we move. And then, if we ever move, I'll find a new place for it. I need it visible at all times. I need to see her visible near my workstation at all times. But that's beside the point. And we'll get into this a little bit later, this People magazine clipping. But for right now, given the fact that two of my all-time favorite institutions in popular culture, at least in my view, are joining forces officially for the first time, oh, there ain't no way I'm not gonna do the Jeopardy book. Now, you want the answers, the questions, the facts, and the stories about the greatest game show in history? You'll find them all here in this HarperCollins publication, picked up for $3.99, out of retail prices of $12.95 in the US and $16.95 in Canada. This is co-authored by the late, great, one and only host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek! Alongside Peter Barsocchini, with an introduction by the creator and executive producer of Jeopardy, the late, great Merv Griffin. Let's get on with this, shall we? We begin with a day in the life of Jeopardy, from head producer George Vosburgh. This was published in 1990, folks. Oh, and yeah, you bet your bottom dollar. In fact, you can actually wager your bottom dollar that there will be some Jeopardy quizzes in here. Standard Jeopardy, Double Jeopardy, Final Jeopardy, across a wide variety of subjects up the wazoo. But this chapter here focuses on a typical day of Jeopardy taping. Gathering all the material, coming up with categories and clues, taping the show itself, going over all the stuff with the contestants, etc., etc. And then, going back up the next day to stage one at the Hollywood Center Studios, where they originally taped the current iteration of Jeopardy, to do it all again. George Vosburgh says here at the end of the chapter, "I'm sure that no one will object if I take this opportunity to introduce the people who make Jeopardy happen, just as their names appear on the crawl at the end of the show. I don't object one bit. We do a lot of folks. You wanna know why? Some people on YouTube actually take the risk of copyright takedowns and upload full-length credit scrolls, theme music and all, with audience applause, as Alex chats with the contestants, or as Ken Jennings or Milam Bilek does nowadays, to actually see all these names go up. Like the way I'm pathetically doing it now. So yeah, I don't judge at all. For some folks, that actually might be their favorite part of Jeopardy, seeing the full closing credits, time permitting. Here we have a black and white photo inset of the show. Now, this was in 1990, folks. They were taping in color. They could have spun for some color photography, but they didn't. But something's better than nothing. You have, of course, announcer Johnny Gilbert, of course, one of the last remaining pillars of Jeopardy's OG era, when he goes, which I hope won't be too soon. But then again, any time for him would probably be too soon. When he goes, we're gonna have a big limbo as to who will replace him, or succeed him. Nobody will replace Johnny Gilbert. But anyway, there he is in his announcing booth. There's the booth with director Dick Snyder. Here we have Alex and host of the French version of Jeopardy, Philippe Rizzoli. There's Alex, of course, chatting up with the producers and writers, researchers, standards practices department, just to make sure all the categories are legit, all the materials legit, etc. That's a part of the roundtable meeting right there. We also have stage manager John Lauderdale, no longer stage manager, recently retired, chatting it up with the College Week contestants, familiarizing them with the set. Jimmy McGuire, formerly a part of the now disbanded Clue Crew, is stage manager. Hollywood Center Studios stage one, the Jeopardy set. The Jeopardy contestants hard at work, some winning, some losing, etc. And of course, the man who made it all happen, who also wrote the theme music for Jeopardy, simply titled Think, Merv Griffin. The original Jeopardy set in 1965 with original host Art Fleming, who gets interviewed by co-author Peter Barsocchini at the end of the book. So we have a lot of behind-the-scenes chapters on Jeopardy. We also have chapters about the categories, the writers, and the unsung heroes of the show, the researchers, the A&Q team, Willie. And what's a Jeopardy book of any kind without some Jeopardy quizzes? In addition to standard Jeopardy quizzes, we also have some teen tournaments, college tournaments, and a tournament of champions quizzes. This one is of mice and women. You see here, Mickey Mouse? I'm profiling this line of clues for one reason and one reason only. Tomorrow, I will begin filming The Wonderful World of Disney Deals. It's my Disney series that I'm doing for the holidays, which will span 2 months. If you want more info, check out some of the links below. But I'm so excited for this. I mean, I can hardly wait to get my Mouseketeer on. But if you don't like Mickey Mouse, this bunch of Jeopardy clues also has Dr. Seuss, the Flintstones, Jetsons, Batman, and Popeye, with answers at the end of each of them. And of course, if you don't answer in the form of a question, you ain't doing Jeopardy right, folks. Now for one of my all-time favorite categories in here, and that would be Movie Madness. If Troian wasn't competing on Celebrity Jeopardy, I probably would have held this off until Odyssey to the Oscars. That's my major TSR Academy Awards series that I do every year. So here we have circus movies, private movies, screen gems, movie artists, more movie authors. This is all about the movies, folks. But standard Jeopardy, we also have double Jeopardy. And by the way, they don't give any specified dollar amounts in these quizzes. I don't know why. I guess they don't want to take a risk of you having to actually wager your money, because then you might get mad if you lose. But come on, when was the last time a Jeopardy contestant got mad when they lost on Jeopardy? Heck, at worst, they were just singing inside of their heads that Weird Al Yankovic song. Anyway, final Jeopardy category, Motion Pictures. The first part of this classic 1959 comedy is set in Chicago in February 1929. What is Some Like It Hot? There's a whole bunch of Jeopardy nostalgia and memories in here. We also have a few words from the contestants, learning about them. To really summarize this would probably take a good long time, but everything you ever wanted to know about the 90s era of Jeopardy, really for the most part, is in here. Are you smart enough? About to celebrate its 20th anniversary on the air, Jeopardy is the most exciting game on television. Filled with the best and toughest quizzes ever written, the Jeopardy book also takes you behind the scenes to see what the show's really like. And here you'll learn how the show was created, what a day in the life of Jeopardy is like, how the board works, how the categories and questions are created, what a contestant's eligibility quiz is like, and you'll also learn startling revelations about Alex's cap collection. Willie, why not his tie collection? You know he was famous for his tie collection, right? Filled with pictures from the show's entire history, stories of the show's biggest winners, and wonderful anecdotes from Alex and above on their experiences, the Jeopardy book is for anyone who's smart enough to enjoy television's greatest moment, Jeopardy. And now we'll move on to a small but significant People magazine clipping from February 28, 2022. Along with a little note of text. Pete, maybe she can do this for Patterson. Be happy and well. Donna. Maybe Troian can do what? Raise money for a community-based organization for kids in Patterson the same way she did for Variety Boys and Girls Club in Los Angeles in Boyle Heights by designing a line of clothing themed after, what else, for her, Pretty Little Liars with the secret hoodie, plus t-shirts and hats. And for her husband, Patrick J. Adams, again, what else? Suits, simply with a tie. Suits and ties go hand in hand. And again, Peter Barsocchini, why not Alex's tie collection? Come on. Anyway, Donna did indeed send this clipping to me. It's Why I Care, personal stories about giving back with Troian Bellisario in her own words, raising money for this venerable institution in Los Angeles. Even though my crush on Troian has, for the most part, died down over the course of the year or so, it's no longer as, to quote my pal Zoe, diagnosable as she thought it was, and even I thought it was. It was still incredibly thoughtful for Donna to send me this. As far as the Jeopardy book goes, despite the all-black and white photograph inset, something's better than nothing. And for you Jeopardy fans, this truly is something. For you nostalgic Jeopardy fans who have a certain penchant for the 90s, heck, I was born in 1998, but that doesn't make this something else any less altogether. Instead of playing the bad game of what if, as if what if you never got this book, start playing the official game of what is. And if you want to give me this clue, the finest quiz show in all of television, there's only one answer. What is Jeopardy? With all due respect to you, Alex, I feel compelled to close this video with a special tribute to the birthday girl, who no doubt will wipe the competition this Sunday on Celebrity Jeopardy. Troian, if by some chance you ever see this, I know how much you like Shakespeare.
I don't like Shakespeare. I love Shakespeare.
Okay, granted, you love Shakespeare. And while I can't give you tickets to Hamlet at the RSC, I'm still on a budget, you know, I can think of two quotes from Hamlet that I think speak volumes about you. To thine own self be true, thou canst not then be false to any man, or today, any woman, or anyone of any gender. And that speaks about you. Whether you're Spencer, Claire, Clara, Olivia, Stella, or anyone else, you are bravely and unapologetically yourself. You are a shining beacon for those who need it the most. And for me, you are simply, in every generational sense of the word, lit. This is not a simple happy birthday. This is more of an ongoing love story for all of us Bellisarians. For now, good night, sweet princess. I love you truly. I always, always have.
Wherever you go, whatever you do, I will be right here waiting for you.
Watching TSR. Now, to see another awesome review like this one, click here. If you want to become a Hollywood bargain hunter, click here to subscribe. And I'll catch you on the thrift side.